Hey, what's up, everyone? Welcome back to the Summer of Carnage right here on the Venom Vlog. This is episode 398. We are getting very close to episode 400. I can't believe we're already here. We've been doing the show for, you know, less than 2 years now, and we've already produced, you know, almost 400 episodes, and it's been a fun ride. I really appreciate all of you guys that have stuck with us since the beginning and all the new people that have come along the way. And today what we're going to do is we're going to do a two-parter, because there was a book that came out this week for Absolute Carnage called Absolute Carnage versus Deadpool, which I have right here. But I thought, you know, before we get into this, I kind of was curious about the first crossover. I had never read it. And you know, it was written by Cullen Bunn. This is written by Frank Thierry. But the original series, which was just called Carnage vs. Deadpool, it was written by Cullen Bunn. And I was like, you know, I want to check it out. And people were telling me, like, hey, the hybrid symbiotes show up in it. Like, the other Life Foundation symbiotes show up in that book. And, you know, they were giving me some, like, tidbits about some of the storyline that was going on. And it sounded intriguing to me. And so I was like, you know what? That's what we should do. So for episode 398, we're going to cover that series, that miniseries that Cullen Bunn did. It's released in graphic novel form. I own the digital copy, and in the digital version of it, there's also an added annual called Superior Carnage Annual 1, which I also have never read, and I've never read Superior Carnage, the miniseries. So we're going to save that annual and that miniseries for later on when we go back into Carnage's history. But today, I just wanted to have some fun and talk about Deadpool and read this miniseries before, you know, as a precursor to this. So the next episode, 399, we will review this issue, and then episode 400 will be me down in Anaheim on Friday, and I'll be trying to record some interviews for you guys for the upcoming Maximum Venom cartoon series. So yeah, we're going to have a lot of fun, and then after 400, we only have 50 episodes left before the season ends, and then we'll get into season 4, which will be Flash Thompson and more, you know, Venom 2 movie news for sure. So let's talk about this miniseries. It's written by Cullen Bunn. Salvador Espin is the artist. I've never seen his work before, before this and now reading this. I've never seen his stuff before, but it was good. I gotta say, overall, my thought and impression of Deadpool vs. Carnage was Freddy vs. Jason. I don't know if that's what Cullen Bunn was going for, but if he was, he nailed it, in my opinion, where it's just like this really goofy, over-the-top, you know, way of telling a story and bringing these two, like, you know, characters together. It was very funny. It starts off and Deadpool is kind of sitting at home. He's watching the news, and there's like, and actually, before I get into that, there's one panel in this book that completely sums up the tone of this book. And so I didn't take a lot of artwork from this because I didn't want to show too much off, because I did get some feedback on that from people about, like, showing too much of the book off. So I want to try to be conscious of that and not give away, you know, basically the books for free or anything like that. So I've cut it down on this one and just have a couple images. But I thought this image right here, right there on the screen, really sums up this the tone of this book, where it's just the two of them stabbing each other and trash talking each other. It's so funny. Like, this book actually made me laugh a couple times. And I would say, even though I smile a lot on the show and I have fun on the show, typically in real life, I don't smile or laugh a lot, typically. So it was fun reading this and just kind of cracking up from here and there, like my moments here and there. So it does start off, and Deadpool's at home, and he's watching TV, and he thinks he's hearing messages from the TV as he's flipping through the channels. Like, he thinks he's hearing a sentence being put together, and he's like, I feel like life is trying to tell me something. And he mentions that that's how someone who isn't of their right mind might think, you know, like the TV's talking to me and all that stuff. He talks about being crazy and out of his mind, and so that's kind of what he plays into. And then he uses that actually becomes like a weird way of how he tracks down Carnage in this series, because Carnage has broken out now, and he's, like, you know, making his way across the country, and we don't really know where, and Carnage is trying to just be sporadic. He's like killing a family here, or he's, like, you know, taking down people over here, or killing people, you know, on a bus or something over here, and he's doing this weird pattern. I think the opening is him in a diner, and he just kills everybody in the diner, and so this book does not hold back, by the way. It is a parental advisory book. It says right on the cover, like, rated mature for you know, for comic fans. So this is not a book actually for you know, I would say under 16 or 17, or maybe even under 18, I guess is probably what they're going for. But it is a gruesome book. I mean, luckily Salvador Espin's artwork is kind of playful and you know, in that way, and the colors are kind of playful, so it doesn't come across as gruesome, but at the same time it is gory. It is gruesome and gory in the sense of, like I said, Freddy versus Jason, where it's like, you know, arm gets chopped off and blood just sprays out, you know, like, just comedically sprays out. And that's kind of how they treat this. And so I don't know, for that reason, it really pulled me into this. Like, I'm not a big Deadpool fan, and I was wondering, like, okay, how are they going to do this? I've read some of Cullen's Deadpool stuff before, and I like some of it, and I liked the Jerry Duggan stuff and the Brian Posehn stuff, and even some of the Daniel Way a little bit. But overall, I'm like, I'm not a big fan of this character, but I do like talking about him sometimes because when he's done well or interesting or just straight funny, I kind of get pulled in. I go, okay, I see the appeal of this guy, and that's what this series did to me. It really pulled me in, and I was like, by the end of the first issue, I was like, okay, this is just Freddy versus Jason. This is them coming up with a silly way for them to meet, and they just go from there. And that's what happens. Like, Deadpool is like, look, I'm the only other crazy person in this universe other than Cletus Cassidy. So who better to hunt him down than me? And the TV told me to. So I'm going to go do that. And then along the way, he meets like with this Uber fan because he went to like this town in Arizona. He fights Carnage once. He gets beat up and Carnage gets away. So he's like, all right, I have a lockbox full of weapons. Let's go do that. And by the way, when he comes after Carnage, it's so awesome. Like, Carnage is sitting there like in a house. He killed the whole family and he's like making breakfast or something. And then all of a sudden a rocket launcher comes through the window and blows up the house. And you find out that Shriek is actually there, and it's almost like a Bonnie and Clyde. It's Carnage and Shriek going across country, like killing people, and so, but you don't even have like any waste of time with the action. Like, once Deadpool finds out where Carnage is, he just goes right there and just starts trying to kill him. There's like another scene where Deadpool gets the Life Foundation symbiotes and he uses one of them as a sniper. He like adds the ability of being a good sniper to him, and he shoots Cletus Cassidy right through the head, and you see like his eyeball come out, and you're just like, good God, like they do not pull back at all in this. They just went, they put that, like I said, I always talk about that in storylines where they put the foot on the pedal and they just never let up. They're just like, ah, screw it, let's just keep going. And it makes for a really fun storyline. At the end of the first issue, when Deadpool, or Carnage gets away, Deadpool finds a fan. Like, he's like, all right, I had a lockbox here, and like, oh, that expired months ago because you didn't keep up with the payments. He's like, well, where is it now? And they're like, oh, some fan, bought it. So he goes to this like guy's house who's like, he's like this big, couple hundred pound guy. He's even wearing the Deadpool suit, but it's like really tight on him. And Deadpool's like, look, man, I need my extra costume and I need these weapons you got for my lockbox. He's like, come on, man, I'm a fan and I'm crazy like you. And so Deadpool's like, well, you can't be that crazy. He's like, yes, I am. Look, I bought all your stuff. And he's like, all right, fine, you're crazy. He goes, well, I got to track down Carnage, so I need all this stuff. And he's like, well, I've been following the Carnage story on the news. And he goes, and or this, I've been following these murders on the news. And if you're telling me it's Carnage, then I think I know where he's going. And Deadpool's like, how do you know that? And he goes, because I'm crazy. And he's like, and I think I know where he's, or I know where Carnage is going. I think I said Deadpool, but he's like, but I think I know where Carnage is going. And Carnage doesn't even know where he's going. And then so Deadpool's like, where? And he goes, Doverton, Colorado. That's the place that he took over during, Carnage USA, and the place he went to during the Cult of Carnage. So this fan thinks that's where Carnage is heading. And so Deadpool's like, all right, I'll basically go on that path and try to, cut him off from getting there. And he does. Eventually Carnage like takes over him, and Shriek, Shriek gets wounded, by the way, by Deadpool. And so she's kind of out of it for like an issue or so. And Carnage kidnaps his family and says, like, drive me, like, where are you guys going? And they're like, oh, we're going on this trip of like visiting weird towns and stuff and haunted places and stuff. And Carnage's like, fine, take me to the next place that's on your destination, or I'll kill your whole family. And then and the guy's like, okay, fine, please don't kill us. And it's like, there's like kids in the back and everything. So the dad drives Carnage and Shriek, who's unconscious, to this new town. And then when Deadpool shows up, figuring out where Carnage is, he shows up and the family's actually dead. And I'll be honest with you, I didn't see that coming. And Deadpool even says that. Deadpool goes, wow, I didn't see that coming. I maybe thought he would have let them go, live or something. So they really ramp up the evilness of Carnage in this one, because I guess they can. They had a mature rating on the book, so they did not pull any punches. And so since that whole family is gone now, Deadpool is even more pissed off. And when he gets wounded, he gets trapped by Carnage, and then his arms and legs get cut off. He's going down into a bunker where he found out that Carnage, basically on the map of weird visits, he wasn't going straight to Doverton. He found this place where the four symbiotes were hiding. So if you remember in Carnage USA, the other Life Foundation symbiotes, not not Scorn, because that was like a new one, and not Scream, because she wasn't around at this point, but you had Phage, Lasher, Agony, and Riot, and the four of them were bonded to these soldiers that were in this bunker underneath this small town, and they're just being waiting to be deployed to go hunt down Carnage, because they heard, and now that the news is starting to piece together that it's him, they're like, okay, this, it looks like this is a Carnage situation here, and he's making his way across the country. So now they're like, okay, we got to get sent in, we got to go take him down, we can't trust that Deadpool's going to do it because they saw him on the news. So like, we need to go bond with our suits. But before they can go into the room where their suits are being held and bond with them, Carnage shows up and kills those four soldiers that were bonded to the suits before in Carnage USA. So yeah, talk about wrapping up some continuity and loose ends. Like, so all four of them get killed, but the suits get away and they bond with Deadpool. And so Deadpool has like Riot and Phage and Agony and Lasher all attached to him, and they're all doing different things. So like, Lasher is, you know, mimicking the dog like it did in Carnage USA, and he's like, all right, track, you know, Carnage for me now. And so Deadpool uses that dog to track Carnage. Then he goes up in a tree and he uses Riot to like zoom in and become like a, you know, a master sniper like he did with the previous human host that he was bonded to. And so Deadpool like brings his A game and just comes in and starts tearing Carnage apart. And he starts talking to Carnage. He says, look, you know, sometimes life is just trying to tell you something. And I saw on the TV that, you know, life wanted me to come after you. And Carnage's like, that's insanity talk. And he goes, I know. He's like, but you're crazy too. So life is probably trying to tell you something. So along the way, when Carnage was like, you know, had that family with him, you know, he picked up some message, like he's like, oh, I wonder if life is trying to tell me something. And he is getting affected by Deadpool's words. Deadpool's like craziness is like starting to seep into Cletus Kasady. So Deadpool's actually out crazying Cletus Kasady. And so in the end, you know, when they're really going at it, and they're fighting and they're decimating each other and they're cutting each other and getting ready to kill each other, Shriek takes a really massive blow. And what he does is Deadpool sends the symbiotes around Shriek to make her look like Deadpool. And they blend in to make her look like Deadpool. And then Carnage comes in and attacks her and almost kills her. And then he realizes that it's Shriek, and the suits slink away and they go back to Deadpool. And he's like, all right, I win. He's like, you just, you know, killed us, the only person you started to ever care about in this lifetime. And Carnage breaks down and he's just like, you know what, I'm done. Like, maybe life is trying to tell me something, and I don't want to, you know, I'm done. We're done. You're right. You win and I lose. And I would say, maybe, I don't know if that's fully in character or feels like it's in character. I can understand, though, they do a fairly good job in the story of showing Carnage being worn down. So at least for the crux of the story, it kind of works in a way. But for a lot of us who know Cletus to just be this crazy guy who, you know, who can't be compromised with and stuff, it seems a little weird, but he does have one weak spot. If you were going to exploit that, I guess, you know, Shriek is the only way to do it. And so he wounds her and she's going to die. And so he decides to stay when the cops arrive and turn himself in, as long as Shriek gets, you know, help from them. And he's like, look, keep her alive and I'll just stay locked up or whatever. And so so that's kind of how this ends. It's like, you know, Deadpool really does kick the crap out of Carnage, and Carnage kicks the crap out of Deadpool right back. But that's how it wraps up, is that Deadpool actually outsmarts Carnage, or outcrazies him in a way, and gets him to do something that, you know, makes him stop, which is, you know, he gets Carnage to attack and seriously wound Shriek. And then at the end, yeah, he just locks himself up. He's just, you know, under wraps. And so he's back, you know, in custody. And then Deadpool is, you know, talking to the four symbiotes. He's like, look, I can't keep you guys. You know, you got to go find a home of your own. And that's when they go and bond to a dog that we see, you know, recently, what we saw in Separation Anxiety, the Absolute Carnage book. And they bond to that dog. And so he's like, hey, you know, go out in the world, find a, you know, host. I can tell you want to try to do good things, or maybe go back to the government bunker and, you know, and have them, you know, find new hosts for you or whatever. He's like, whatever makes you happy, just go do it. And he goes, and I'm going to go my own way now that I know that, you know, Carnage is locked up and that I, you know, mission complete or whatever. So that's kind of how the book ends. And I was like, ah, man, I'm not 100% on board with that to an extent, but I mean, I understand, like, you know, writing a storyline, the way you have to structure things and the way you want things to pay off if you set them up. Cullen Bunn did want to show that Deadpool maybe is the craziest dude in the Marvel Universe and lives up to that title, even so much to the point that Carnage, as much as Carnage hates Deadpool throughout this and hates dealing with him, and even to Carnage where he's like, I don't even really know, you know, Carnage doesn't even really know anything about Deadpool. When he hits him and wounds him, he sees him heal and he's like, how are you alive? So it's like Carnage is so oblivious. He's been in his own world of Spider-Man all these years that he's completely oblivious to someone like a Deadpool. And even Deadpool, he's like, I kind of know what Carnage is, but even that, like, he wasn't ready for when he fought Carnage and brought the he brought a lot of weapons at him. He like turned on speakers on his belt to try to like use the sonics to like disrupt him or whatever. And that only worked so long until Shriek showed up and popped in. So it's like he was kind of planning to fight a symbiote. He was thinking of like Venom. He's like, well, I've run into Venom a few times, and I think at this point Venom and Deadpool were teammates in the Thunderbolt comic book under Flash Thompson Venom. So I think this was around that time. So he's like, yeah, I've hung out with Venom enough. I know his weaknesses, fire, sonics, but a lot of that stuff wasn't working as well on Carnage because, Carnage was born in Earth's atmosphere and he works a little bit differently than Venom. He still has those weaknesses, but they're not always, the same level. Like you have to really amp it up to really hurt him with those. Like they had to drop Carnage into a concert, I think at one point, and just blast speakers in his face. So it has to be more than little speakers on your belt, basically. Basically. So yeah, anyway, the storyline was fun though. If you've ever read it, you probably maybe feel the same way, maybe you don't. I'd love to hear your thoughts on Deadpool versus Carnage down below in the comment section. If you have any comments you made, anything I skipped over that you want to talk about, let me know down below. And as always, we'll continue our conversation down there. But overall, I liked it. It was fun. And I can't wait now. I haven't read this yet, Absolute Carnage vs. Deadpool. So I'm going to stop this episode and then read this and then record my episode for a review of this. So now I'm excited. Now that I'm caught up and I know how the life symbiotes ended up on that dog that ended up in separation anxiety. Like now things are starting to come together and it's like, man, this little pocket era of Venom books and Carnage books that I missed out on, it's nice reading them and catching up on them. So hopefully you enjoyed this episode and hopefully you've read this yourself. And if you haven't, I definitely recommend you go in to buy it. Like I said, make sure you're over like 18 or so, because it is very graphic and very detailed on some of the stuff they do in there, but not gruesome. Like I said, the artwork's kind of fun, so it treats it more like a camp kind of violence, like Freddy versus Jason. But still, if you're not don't want that kind of stuff in your typical storytelling comic books, then I'd say stay away from it. But if this is your cup of tea and you like Deadpool and you like Carnage, I can't recommend it enough. It was a lot of fun. Thanks so much for watching this episode, as always, and we will see you in the next episode 399 with Absolute Carnage versus Deadpool. Thank you. See you in the future. Peace.